Hi there. Until today, I believe that it was the Jason report on the Ronald Reagan that first outlined the problem of climate change, the fact that it was man-made. Of course, Mr. Tyndall had proposed a theory that carbon dioxide could be possible for global warming in the 1850s already, but I didn't know that it was clearly outlined as a theory, as a concept, from A to Z, already in 1957, between 1957 and 1959. And I can give you the audio here. This is from a record from General Electric, one of the big industrial firms. So they, of course, also knew about this.
Do man's puny efforts make any significant change in the carbon dioxide balance? Very significant. The burning of coal, oil, and wood in industrial processes and other human activity is releasing 6,000 million tons of carbon dioxide into the atmosphere each year. Dr. Plass says that after balancing out the contribution from the organic world, this man-made contribution is larger than any of the natural contributions. If all this extra carbon dioxide stays in the atmosphere and no other conditions change, man is actually causing the average temperature to rise 2 degrees per century. And man will probably add more and more as the years go on, I suppose. Yes, Dr. Plass believes that any reasonable projection of our industrial activity indicates that it will continue to increase for many years. Direct measurement of the carbon dioxide in the atmosphere tends to show that the carbon dioxide content has gone up 10% during the last half century. This is exactly the amount that has been added to the atmosphere by industrial activity during this period.
So, well, if you want to basically run your country or your economy on any basis, any rational basis, any basis of optimization, and this knowledge was around, and they knew basically that they were changing the temperature 2 degrees per century with what they were doing, the way they were doing it. And they could figure out pretty easily the devastating effect it would have on agriculture, on land use, on the migration of animals, on all kinds of species in the world. But yet they decided to go on. Then it sounds really like this was a generation that just wanted to play around, that just wanted to have a good time on Earth and leave it in whatever state they left it without caring for anybody. And we can see that in a financial sense too, of course, because the politicians have pillaged all the reserves that were actually intended to take care of these baby boomers. But they are, it is a criminal offense to the younger generation to know that in 57 they knew, in 79 they knew, in 88 they talked about it, in 94 they talked about it, in 2000 they talked about it, and nothing happened. It's really disgusting, and I think they should all pay for this.